that this little flat, pale piece of dough, when baked, can turn into this wonderful puffy object. This is French puff pastry, pâte feuilletée, or millefeuille, which it means it has almost 1,000 layers to it, and it's tender and tasty, one of the most beautiful doughs. And Michel Richard is going to teach us how to make it, and he's about the best puff pastry maker in this whole country, if not...
Not the best. Well, one
of the very best.
Good one. To make a puff pastry, we need 1 pound of pastry flour. All right, and then we need 1.5 teaspoon of salt. We need 1 cup of water.
1 1/4 cup.
1 1/4.
1 1/4.
I don't read well. I'm glad you are here to help me. And then we're going to process it until we create a nice little ball. That's it. 2 seconds. Let's remove the dough from the machine. You see, the dough is in rubbery, but not firm. It's easy to work with. Create a nice little ball. I'm going to cut the top. I cut the top of the dough to cut the rubberiness of the dough. You have to cover the dough with a wet towel for a few minutes. And I'm going to pound the butter. This is 1 pound of sweet butter. We have to use the butter when the butter just came out from the fridge. We want the butter to be firm. Make sure the butter is cold. Okay, just pound the butter. Nice square. And you roll the dough. Okay, this is a little thicker in the middle.
No, that's interesting. Yeah. Why do you want that?
Because, you know, they're going to overlap.
Oh, I see. So that'll make it even.
Yeah. You reverse the butter in the middle of the dough.
That's a very clever way of doing it.
See?
Yeah.
Because you're going to have 3 layers on top of each other.
Yeah. So neat. Nice. Yeah.
There we are. And then you... a little bit. Mm-hmm. Well, yeah, a bit more flour.
You're very careful to keep it in a rectangle all the time.
Yes. And in flour, make sure the dough won't stick.
Yeah.
You will hold it. You're going to do 2 turns. Because when you do a puff pastry, you do like 6 turns.
Mm-hmm. To make the layers.
Like this one. This is 1 turn.
Yeah. It's terribly important that it keep very cold, isn't it?
Yes, very cold. The way the butter's going to melt, it's going to go through the dough, and we're going to have
a... Then every time you do that, there's a thin layer of butter
between
the leaves. That's what makes 1,000 leaves.
Here we are, second turn. And now we're going to have to refrigerate for 1/2 hour. 1, 2 turns to chill.
That's so that you know.
That's why I know. Anyway, I just did 2 turns.
Mm-hmm. And you have to do...
I want
to do
2 more in half an hour.
Yeah.
And we will wait 1/2 hour after that. Mm-hmm. And just before using it, you're going to do 2 more turns.
And that's a damp towel.
Yeah. And you have to...
refrigerate it.
For 1/2 hour.
When you've been on a puff pastry making spree, you'll end up with a lot of scraps like this. Or you may go to the store and you may buy some ready-made puff pastry. And pastry chef Michel Richard is going to show us some wonderful recipes on what to do with these things.
I have a good recipe, and they serve that kind of tart in Alsace-Lorraine.
Oh.
It's a very thin tart with onion and bacon. You know what they used to do in Alsace? On the way to the church, they used to bring the uncooked tart to the baker, and the baker was baking the tart while they were praying God.
Uh-huh.
And after the church, they used to pick up the tart.
Well, that's
good. Okay, here I have some scraps.
Those are just scraps.
Yeah. Renew.
You just sort of bunch them all together, roll it out.
In a little ball, and then you roll it into... very, very thin.
That's a nice cold marble you've done.
See what I did before?
What?
I had the garbage bag full of ice.
Oh, so here. And I chilled it.
Yeah.
That's a good idea, because it has to be very cold, doesn't it?
It's easier to work with. And Okay, and then we're gonna play some music. You know?
Mm-hmm.
After cool. We do that because you don't want the dough to puff.
I see. Oh, it's puff paper. You don't want it to puff.
That's right. And then we have like a cardboard.
It's a template, you know.
Yeah. Okay.
And you're gonna make some more Ronier.
Some more Ronier. And then I'm gonna show you how to use the Ronier of the Ronier.
Fine.
Okay. And you need a tray. Can you give me the tray?
There you are. A buttered tray.
And you transfer it. Okay. It's easy to transfer it. Mm-hmm. Okay. Now we're gonna have to store the tart into the refrigerator while we are cooking the onion and saute the bacon.
Yeah, I'll put it in the fridge, okay? Well, we're starting the tart.
Yes, we need an onion, a big onion. I'm going to cut the onion in small dice, very small dice. You have to make sure that you have the right knife. The knife has to cut well, otherwise you are going to cry. See?
I'll do that.
See, you don't need the food processor to do that.
No.
By the time you look and you find the blade, it's over. 2 minutes. You need 2 minutes to do that. And we are going to cook the onion with a cup of chicken stock. At my home, I make my own chicken stock, but when I'm lazy, I buy the chicken stock.
I like the way I think everyone's got to practice on onions, don't you think?
Right. Okay, here we have.
I'll turn this on for you.
We have to. The onion. The chicken stock. No salt. Because
no
we have
salt.
To taste. We have to taste. Maybe no. a little bit of fresh ground pepper. A little bit at the start, and you have to add some fresh at the end.
Mm-hmm.
And we bring that to a boil, and we are going to cook it for 30 minutes until the onion is translucent.
We have some ready on. We have some that we did ahead.
Yeah.
Do we want them?
Yeah, we have it.
And that's in that. It's beautiful.